everybody, welcome to our channel, Ness and Sophie. My name's Nessa, and this here is my cavapoo puppy named Sophie. Thanks so much for checking out our videos. Please hit that subscribe button if you want to see more. We're sharing lots of awesome videos and you don't want to miss a thing. Now, I'm really excited for today's video because I've had some people message me on both YouTube and Instagram. If you want to follow us on Instagram, I have the link down below in the description box. That would be so awesome if you do. And people have been messaging me trying to figure out how I get Sophie to sleep for so long at night. Typically, she will sleep about 10 hours every night. Now, of course, this doesn't include when we first brought her home because for the first 2 to maybe 3 months, she had a lot of time getting used to her crate and sleeping the whole night long. But now she goes to bed at around 10 o'clock and she doesn't wake up until 8. And it would probably be even longer if she didn't hear me awake as well. Today I'll be sharing with you 3 tips on how I get Sophie to sleep soundly the whole night long. These will work if you have a large space or a small space, and they even help if you have a restless or anxious dog that needs to be kept busy. Each of these tips also have an added bonus that I think all dog owners will definitely enjoy. One thing I always do with Sophie every day is provide opportunities for physical exercise. Sophie has a wide variety of toys. As you can see, the collection grows more and more every day, and she loves playing with her toys. What I really like to do to exercise her, especially when I want her to be calm in her crate, is I'll choose 2 of her smaller toys that are easier for her to bring back and play a game of fetch. Now, this can be done inside or outside. I prefer inside because it can get quite cold outside. And all I do is throw 1 toy and wait for her to go and get it and bring it back, and then toss the 2nd toy. Not only does this have her racing back and forth to get both toys, but I also use it as an opportunity to train the drop it commands along with the go get it and bring it back commands. I'll usually do this in the morning before I go back to work, so we get to spend quality time together before she goes in her crate for the morning, and I'll also do this on my lunch break as well. We also go for about a 30-minute walk every day unless it's super cold or really wet. Then we'll do extra playtime activities inside. Taking a walk in the morning is a great bonding opportunity for you and your pet if you'll be leaving them alone for the day, because spending time with you in the morning will help ease their loneliness during the day. And it also provides time for them to socialize with other dogs and people, encounter new smells, and so many other amazing benefits. I also really enjoy mental stimulation. It's a great way to get your dog focused on an activity, and I've heard it's also great at stopping problem behaviors like chewing on furniture and even separation anxiety. I use 3 different things to mentally stimulate Sophie. I use a puzzle feeder to give her food either in the morning or at night, and this is great for cavapoos because they can be picky eaters. I also love using a snuffle mat because I hide all kinds of goodies in there, even Sophie's dog food, and she can spend 30 minutes trying to find everything in the mat. She gets really excited every time I bring out her snuffle mat because she knows that there's always a very special treat hidden really well inside the mat, so she really takes her time trying to find it. And also, a Kong toy is a really great toy to have. You can spread some peanut butter or pumpkin puree with special treats hidden inside, and your dog is sure to spend time trying to get all the yummy stuff inside. And I use this all the time for Sophie, especially when I put her in her crate and I'm planning on leaving. In order to help with her separation anxiety, it's nice to have a special treat and something that'll keep her busy in her crate while I'm gone. The last way I get my puppy tuckered out is actually the easiest thing you can do. When Sophie was only a few months old, she would start to fall asleep and stay asleep at around 7 at night. Now, puppies need their sleep, that's very important, but I started to notice that when she took this very long nap before bed, she would wake up really early in the morning. And what I started doing every once in a while was giving her these no-hide chew sticks to keep her stimulated at night. And most pet stores should carry something like this. These are easily digestible, and Sophie really enjoys the peanut butter and chicken flavors. And I decided to give her these because they are a healthy and tasty way for her to stay awake instead of sleeping too much before bed and taking away her night's sleep. Of course, I don't give her one of these every night, and it's really important to remember to supervise your pets when you give them something like this, and to check that they are also the best fit for the age and size of your dog. But sticks like these are a great way to keep your pet stimulated, and they also help clean your dog's teeth, which is a great added bonus. There you have it.
these are the three ways that I get this adorable puppy pooped out and sleeping soundly through the night. Of course, it took some time for me to get to know my puppy and find things that she enjoyed and that kept her entertained. Give these tips a try. Let me know how it goes. Send us any ideas you may have. If you have any questions or if you'd like to request a video of what you'd like to see next, please leave a comment down below. If you'd like to support our channel, please subscribe for more. Thank you so much for those who have already subscribed, and thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.